new 30-day boarding train in. His name is Zeke. Just this leash up here, right behind his ear, so I can control him a little bit better. Kind of like a steering wheel whenever it's up there. His name's Zeke, and he's a boxer, and he's here because, he's here because of anxiety. He's chewing up things because he gets bored, and he's super, super anxious, as you can already tell. And right now, see this, what he's doing right now, that's avoidance. Because I've barely put any pressure on him, but the fact that I pulled on him just a little bit with that leash, that's giving him a little bit of anxiety. He doesn't really want much to do with me, so he's avoiding. He's looking at everything but me. So, and I'm sure he's a little bit spoiled as well. So we're going to have to work on all that. And she's telling me that he's pretty much a blank slate. He doesn't even know sit. Day or anything, and he may or may not know his name. We didn't talk about that. Zeke! Yeah, he knows his name. Never mind, he knows his name. Good boy. Now, will he come to it off-leash? That's the question. We'll find that out later. But for right now, all I'm going to do is see pretty much how he responds to the leash pressure, and see if he's able to take any direction at all. And again, with these older dogs, you guys already know I'm not big on giving the older dogs treats. I just want to know what they're going to do. I might do that a little bit later, but these next few days, it's just going to be me kind of trying to see what makes him tick and seeing how he responds to pressure, like I already talked about, and seeing what I can and can't make him do. Like, am I going to give him a correction and he's going to run away, or am I going to give him a correction and he's going to take it and be fine and work off that, or am I going to jerk on the leash and give him a correction and he's going to come climbing up the leash and go after my face? We don't know. That look kind of gave me, that look that he just gave me right a few seconds after this video just started kind of concerned me a little bit. I gave him that little correction. I mean, he's obviously, I don't think he's ever seen correction. At least not a leash correction. I think she's been getting after him about tearing things up. He tore up her couch and some other crap. But it's mainly just anxiety. But like I just said, he gave me that weird little look. And I don't know if you could really tell on the video, but I gave him that correction and he just kind of, he gave me that weird little boxer stare that they do. Boxers are interesting to train. They're about the only dog that I have a hard time predicting what they're going to do. But that's kind of what makes them fun, not knowing what they're going to do. It's a good little learning experience for me. Okay, so I'm going to see if I can at least get him to sit. See? Oh, good. He just did. He's just doing it naturally now. And then the avoidance. Hey. Come here. Right here. Hey. No. No avoiding. Nope. Sit. That's the look I'm talking about. I don't know what he's going to do whenever he gives me that look. I'm going to do this. So I can walk into him. I'm going to do that leash thing so I can walk into him without... You know, if he lunges at me, if I got the leash right here, if he lunges at me, I can just and push him back. He's not a very big dog, so it shouldn't be a big issue. Now he's acting good. I think it would actually take a little bit more than that to make him want to lunge at me. But just that look, he's like, what are you, he's like, what the fuck are you doing? What do you think you're doing? What gives you the right to tell me what to do and put that pressure on me? He'll get over it. He's a stubborn breed, so I work with those all the time. Bad boy, Zeke. And then you got your avoidance again. Zeke, come around. And I may eventually use treats to kind of focus him, but I'm not going to do that today. And I might do it tomorrow, but I kind of doubt it. If anything, it'll be like further in this week. I don't even actually know what day it is.
But a couple days at.
A couple days after this is whenever I'll start doing that.
Zeke!
Good. Sit. Sit.
Sit.
Put a little pressure on him. He's kind of focusing now.
We're going to do
a little exercise that I do with some of these higher strung dogs. I'm going to walk in one direction, and then as soon as he starts thinking about something else, as soon as I can tell that he's thinking about something else, I'm going to switch directions. And that's going to play into that focus training that I was talking about. It's going to be like, oh crap, I got to pay attention to where he's going. And that'll also teach him about the pressure of the leash. And at some point, I'll probably put him outside and hook him up to that fence out there for a few minutes and just leave him on his own and let him figure out that he just needs to give up and give in to that pressure and just, like, lay down or sit or whatever. And I'll probably be working some other dogs around him while we're doing that, while he's hooked up. And, yeah, that'll teach him patience and leash pressure at the same time, so that'll be good. And then I'll be able to know whether or not he's going to get pissed off and start barking and bitching and moaning. And then we'll address that as needed. But yeah, most dogs you can just leave hooked up and just ignore them and eventually they'll give up. But some dogs don't give up and you got to go over and correct them, which you got to be careful doing that, because if they're in that state of mind where they're barking and all pissed off and nervous or whatever they are, anxious, anything, you go over and correct them, they're hooked up to a damn fence. So they can't flight. Most dogs want to flight. A dog's either flight or attack. Flight or fight. Yeah, that's what I meant to say. And if he's hooked to a fence, he can't. He can't flight, so what's he going to do? He's either going to give in or he's just going to attack. So you got to watch yourself on that. I don't think he's going to have too many issues. Most things I can stop before they happen. So that's good. And then that keeps him from, you know, getting into the habit where he wants to bite. If I correct him when he's about to bite, right before he does it, then that'll just extinguish that behavior. It won't ever become a habit. So that'll be good. But he's in the stage right now where I don't know what he's going to do. So it's interesting.
Sit.
I'm going to give him a sit.
Then we're going to do that little exercise.
Sit. Good. See, he got a little uppity and he's like, what the fuck are you doing? He was confused, and
he was also like,
this son of a bitch coming up and challenging me. How dare he? Come on, Zeke. Who's he? And then see, he's pissed off, so he's doing that behavior after I got him to do what I wanted him to do. So now he doesn't want anything to do with me at all, which is what he was doing at the very first part of this video. And then I kind of got his focus back, and then now he's upset because he did something that he didn't want to do, and he still had to do it, you know?
And eventually he'll get over that.
He'll eventually get to the point where he just likes to learn focusing on something else.
Here.
Directions, I just disengaged that behavior. He was was in a certain state of mind, and I exchanged directions, and I just disengaged.
Come on. Got anything about, like, right here? See? See what I mean? Using pressure and redirection at the same time. That's, and look at his face right now. See that face? Hey, sit. Just sit. I don't know if you guys can tell, but see his face? Look at that face. He's a lot, I don't know if you can see it on the video, but he's in a better mood right now. He wants that. He wants that. Like, he wants to have somebody to lead him. And he just hasn't had that. And that's what dogs live for. They live to be man's best friend, you know? And they look to us to tell them what to do. And so even if they don't want to do what you're telling them to do, once you get them to do it, they get to the point where they'll actually like doing it because it's natural for them. They wanna have a leader. It's just part of their the way they're designed. They're basically designed to be led by humans or other dogs. Either way, led by somebody. That's what they want. Come on,
let's go, boy.
Yes, that's a very good dog. Come on. Good boy. Look at that nice heel that he just did for a split second. Come on, buddy. Good dog. Like right here. Look at that. Perfect focus right now. Good boy. Sit. Sit. Nah, you don't want to sit right here. Sit. Good dog. Now he's engaged with me. Without any treats or anything. So I might not ever use treats with him. If I can get away with not using treats, I won't at all. Because I would rather him work for me and not a treat. Now, obviously, you guys have seen, at the end of most training sessions, I'll give a bonus treat, a little bit of dog food, a handful of dog food. And that's just showing my appreciation for them doing what is asked for. And basically, a paycheck. And I think it does make a difference. I think it... Once they get to the point, good. I think that once they get to the point where they're expecting a payment for a job well done, I think it makes them work better for me anyway. That's what I think.
Good. Good boy.
Good boy. Yes, sit. Sit. Climbing up the leash. Good boy. He went into that negative state of mind. And then he immediately, he took himself out of that state of mind. I didn't even really do that. I helped a little bit, but he pretty much did that on his own. He's a smart boy, that's for sure. Come on. Good. Yeah. You're so smart. You want to try for a down? I feel like that's going to cause some issues. So let's do it anyway. That's a good set. Hey. Down. Down. No. Sit. Don't bite my face. Give me 2 sets. I'm going to try the pressure thing that I do most of the time. Just hold him down, and the only way to get out of that pressure is to just lay down. And I might have to show him. I might have to show him that that's how you're going to get out of that pressure. I'm just kind of helping out just a little bit. No, that's not going to work. No. I'm going to try to get him to sit. Get him to sit. Now.
Look down for me. Kind of getting to look down so that I can. And I'm going to praise the shit out of him once he gets this done. No. Good boy! Yes! Yes, and then I'm going to immediately let him get back up. I don't expect him to hold that command since he doesn't know it. We'll get into that stuff a little bit later. Look at that face. He's happy that I'm happy. Yes, look. Good boy. You smell good. You smell really good. Yes, she wants to get him in the bath. Come here. Oh, you look happy. You look happy. Hang down. No? Sit. The feet up. Got a tiny neck. It keeps sliding down, dude. Look down for me. Come on. Hey, I know you're smart. You know how to get out of this. Come on. Look down. He does look down. It's gonna be weird. Good. Come on. No. Good. Keep going. You gotta get out of that pressure. You're okay. Hey. No. I know. Hey. No. Stop. Avoidance. Again. Okay, so I'm not gonna keep that up because he's getting super stressed out. I will work on that at a later date. I just wanted to see what I'm working with right there. Sit. Avoidance because of the whole incident. Sit. Good. Yeah. I'm gonna try to get him in a plain state. Good boy. That jumping shit will get corrected at some point. Right now, I'm only worried about his state of mind. I want him happy. Yeah, you got it. Good. Hey, no. A little fighting there. Not too bad. That's a good boy. That's a good boy. Yeah. He's so smart. Front. He doesn't know front, but he knows how to get into that position just through my body language. He's a smart dog. So I'll just start saying front whenever I do that, and then he'll just associate it, the command with the action. So that'll be good. Yeah. Here, come over here. Good.
Heel.
Again, doesn't know that. But it's not going to hurt anything to say it. Good. He's going to be a fun one to train. I can already tell. But I'll hop off this video and get to working with this crazy little fun guy. And I'll let y'all get back to what you're up to. And I'll see y'all later.